Hi, and welcome back to a new Animating with Spine video. This time, we're going to tackle another of the 12 animation principles, anticipation. Almost every animation needs some form of anticipation, making it very important to think about. Anticipation prepares the viewer for an action and directs their focus to what is important. Then, when the action occurs, the anticipation makes the action feel believable and realistic. The great part is that it is a fairly simple principle to grasp, and it can be applied to both simple and complex animations. Almost every animation will have some form of anticipation. It can be left out, but only when there is a good reason. So, what does it look like? Anticipation is the action before the action. It is that part that directs the viewer's focus to what is important and sets their expectations, preparing them for what is about to happen. Actions in animation can happen very fast. For example, throwing a ball can take only 2 or 3 frames to complete. That's not enough time for the viewer to see and understand what is happening. However, if the character winds up before the pitch, the events taking place become a lot clearer. Anticipation allows the viewer to predict the action, so when it happens, it's expected and not an abrupt surprise. When animated well, it gives a sense of realism to the movement, regardless of the realism of the character itself. While the most important use of anticipation is to make a character's action clear, it can also give insight into the character's thoughts. Before a character can take most actions, they must think and plan. A character that is about to jump first needs to crouch down low, then push off with its feet. One common way to add anticipation is to move in the opposite direction first. With that in mind, it can be easier to see the anticipation in many different animations. Anticipation can be a great way to increase contrast to emphasize an action. In a facial animation that needs to show surprise, we will obviously have a surprise pose with an open mouth and eyes. But that reaction can feel even bigger if we first have the character squash their face for a few frames to maximize the change to the action pose. The preparatory movements are what convey an action's power. The more powerful the action, the more exaggerated the anticipation needs to be. You can think of anticipation as gathering the force that needs to be released. You can have a character zip out of the screen or even disappear completely. If the anticipation is done right, the action will be clear. When there is no anticipation, it means that the character didn't have time to plan or prepare their movement. Like when falling accidentally or getting hit unexpectedly. You don't want to use anticipation in these actions because they are a surprise to the viewer as well as to the character. Anticipation is one of the most important principles for game animation because players aren't just passively observing the movement for the character on screen. They often have to respond to it. They need visual cues they can react to, and anticipation is what provides them. Enemies telegraph their attacks using anticipation that is long enough for the player to react. Without it, the gameplay would be surprising and unfair. When it comes to the player character, anticipation can be difficult because when a player presses a button, usually the action should happen quickly. Often, responsive controls end up more important than beautiful animations. Sometimes, you can sneak an anticipation pose into the earliest frames of an action. For example, when the jump button is pressed, the player could snap briefly to a crouch pose. Another way to sell the power of a player action is to extend the recovery time rather than the preparation. This can show how much exertion was needed for such a powerful action, without affecting gameplay by spending time on anticipation. Sometimes there is so little time available that the animator can only sneak in the feeling of an anticipation pose. In Spine Boy's jump animation, he goes right into the stretch pose of the jump, giving the sense that there was a squash pose before that, even though there actually was not. This leads us to today's exercise. We will use the flower sack skeleton we made in one of our Spine Tips videos. We will make 3 different jump animations with different timings. The first animation is the jump and recovery time of a sack without any restriction. Just animate what feels good to you. The second animation only allows an anticipation time of 3 frames. The third animation is a jump without any anticipation. I will start by animating a jump with anticipation time that looks and feels good to me. I highly recommend you animate this for every new character you build, because it gives you a really good understanding of the character's physical properties. Think of doing this exercise as the research necessary to animate your character well. Jumping straight into more complex animations may feel like saving time, but the quality will suffer. If you're short on time, you could instead animate a bouncing ball that represents how your character should move, just like we did in the squash and stretch video. That's it, this looks good to me, so I will move to the second animation. The second animation only allows an anticipation time of 3 frames. Since I've already animated the jump with a lot of anticipation, it's easy to reduce the number of frames, but I still need to adjust the keys a bit. When you have a limited number of keys, every key counts. Really think through the timing and spacing of every element of your character. In this case, the spine and the ears of the sec are important. In more complex characters, you will have arms and legs and other elements you will have to consider. With such little time for anticipation, it must be very clear and easy to read. The last animation is without anticipation. I reworded the starting pose to fit better with the rest of the animation. The goal here is to have the jump of pose look like there was anticipation, even though there wasn't. To see how this will show in your game, open Preview, where you can mix animations to see how they will blend. For me, all of the animations could work, depending on the type of game you're building. It's always important to work closely with the designers and respect the boundaries they give you for the gameplay. I like to start with a movement that looks believable, making the anticipation as long as necessary. During this process, I count the frames and better understand the whole animation. Once I have built the anticipation that feels good, it's easy to reduce the number of frames to get a similar effect, because I have already studied what a character needs to do for the action to be clear and readable. Our eyes are drawn to moving objects, and anticipation is a great tool to prevent the audience from missing some vital action. It may not be a tool that game animators can use quite as often as we would usually like, but it is still one of the most important animation principles for games. Never forget about anticipation when planning your animation. Until next time, have fun and happy animating!